Hello everyone, once again welcome to our physics class. Hope you all are fine over there. Children, in the previous session we had discussed about Faraday's laws and Lenz's law. Also we derived an expression for motional EMF of a conductor moving in a magnetic field, uniform magnetic field. Today let's discuss about the induction in detail. There are two types of induction, self-induction and mutual induction. So today let's discuss about the self induction and also derive an expression for self inductance. Okay, so children, let's get started with today's session. Children, as discussed in our introductory video, let's talk about eddy currents. So eddy currents is not like our induced current. Instead of coil, if we place a conductor in a changing magnetic field, we get some circulating currents. Or at the same time, if the conductor is moving in an external magnetic field, again some circulating currents are set up. These circulating currents are known as eddy currents. That means eddy currents are the induced currents in the body of a conductor when subjected to a changing magnetic flux. And these currents are in the pattern of eddies. Eddies means this type of patterns. These patterns are known as eddies and they look like ripples in water. Okay, so such pattern of circulating currents was first observed by Foucault. Foucault is the name of a scientist. Hence, this pattern is also known as Foucault pattern. Okay, so consider an electromagnetic here. You know how an electromagnetic, a simple electromagnet is constructed. Just take an iron nail and wrap a wire in the form of helix over that nail and connect the ends of the wire to a cell. When the circuit is switched on, it forms an electromagnet. Okay, and if a conductor is placed on the top of, if a conductor means if a metallic sheet is placed on the top of this electromagnet or iron nail, circulating currents are formed in this pattern and this current is known as eddy current. So here the circulating currents set up in the body of a conductor is known as eddy current. Again, consider another example. Consider north and south of a magnet. Now, a copper plate is suspended here. Let this be a copper plate. A copper plate is suspended here. Now, this copper plate is free to oscillate between the pole pieces of the magnet. And what is the direction of magnetic field here? From north to south. So when this copper plate is allowed to oscillate, the copper plate oscillates between the magnetic field. That means the plate is moving across the magnetic field. If conductor is moving in an external magnetic field, there will be a change in the magnetic flux associated with that conductor. And whenever there is a change in the magnetic flux, EMF is induced. And due to that, what happens? Current is induced in the conductor. And these currents will be set up in the form of eddies because it is a conductor. It's not a coil. So whenever a conductor comes, eddy currents are set up in that conductor. And the direction of that in EMF is such that it opposes the increase in flux. That means it opposes the motion of this conductor. Motion of the conductor is responsible for the changing flux. And the induced EMF always try to oppose the cause, oppose its cause. That means oppose the motion of the conductor. Okay, so whenever the metallic plate reaches near the magnetic field, electrons inside the copper plate starts to move and they will move in such a way that it opposes the increase in flux, that is movement of the conductor across the magnetic field. So the speed of the oscillation decreases as time goes on. At last it comes to rest. This is what is called damping. Okay, and this eddy currents are given by induced EMF. So what will be the expression for that eddy currents? Eddy current I is equal to induced EMF by R. And this is the expression for induced EMF divided by R. R means resistance. Okay, then equal to, as per Faraday's law and Lenz's law, what is the expression for induced EMF E? Induced EMF E is minus d phi by dt. When we combine both the Faraday's and Lenz's law, induced EMF E is equal to minus d phi by dt. So substitute for EMF E here, so you will get d phi by dt into R. This is the expression for eddy currents. And the direction of this eddy current is same as that of induced current. The only difference is that eddy currents are found in the body of a conductor and resembles eddies in water. Okay, in the coil we will get an induced current. At the same time in the body of the conductor we will get eddy current. Now, here this metallic, consider the same metal plate, copper plate, suspended freely. In the absence of magnetic field, the copper plate keeps on oscillating. No damping can be seen if we neglect the air resistance. But in the presence of magnetic field, it is found that metal plate oscillates and stops after some time. That is, damping is there. And you had already studied about damping in your previous class. So what is the cause for this damping? See, the metal plate is entering into a magnetic field and going out. That means it is crossing the magnetic field. So there will be a change in the magnetic flux associated with the metallic plate. Whenever the plate enters the magnetic field, more flux will be associated with it. As it leaves the magnetic field, the number of flux associated with the metal plate decreases. So there will be a change in the magnetic flux associated with the metal plate. So due to this, a current is induced, and as per Lenz's law, the direction of current is such that it opposes the change in flux, and the change in flux is caused by the movement of the plate. So this current always tries to oppose the motion of the plate. Okay, so that is the peculiarity of the eddy currents. Eddy currents is also opposes the motion just like induced current. And eddy currents play an important role in damping too. Now, what are the advantages of eddy currents? Some advantages are there. That is, the first application or advantage is that it is used in electromagnetic brakes. Eddy currents are applied in electromagnetic brakes, and you know what is the role of electromagnetic brakes. It controls the speed of fast moving trains. Okay, and the next application is electromagnetic damping. So whenever the coil oscillates in the magnetic field, eddy currents are set up in the frame. This opposes the oscillations and damping is produced very quickly. This helps for quick measurements. Okay, and the third application is induction furnace. The metal to be heated is placed in a rapidly varying magnetic field produced by high frequency AC. Eddy currents are set up. It produces much heat so that the metal melts. Okay, so the metal, what is the purpose of induction furnace? Induction furnace is usually used to melt the metals and all those things. So the metal to be heated is placed in a rapidly varying magnetic field. And whenever the metal is in a varying magnetic field or changing magnetic field, the eddy currents are set up in that metal. And due to the eddy currents, large amount of heat is produced, due to which the metal melts. This eddy currents are always associated with large amount of heat generation. Okay, and what is the next advantage? That is induction motor. Eddy currents are also applied in induction motor. In the induction motor, a rotating magnetic field is produced with the help of two single phase AC. Okay, so that is induction motor. And you know what is the purpose of induction motor? Yes, the motor is usually used in all rotating instruments. Okay, so that's all about the advantages or applications of eddy currents. And what are the disadvantages of eddy currents? So even though advantages are there, some disadvantages also there. And the most important disadvantage is that the eddy currents are always associated with the dissipation of large amount of electrical energy in the form of heat. Okay. Overheating of metallic cores of transformers, electric motors and other devices is observed due to this eddy currents. And because of change in magnetic flux, that change increases more current is because of change in magnetic flux increases, more current is induced and more heat is generated. Okay, so eddy currents increases on magnetic field. Due to this, overheating of devices occur. Now, next is how can we minimize this eddy currents? So the eddy currents can be minimized by using a metal plate with slots. So consider a simple metallic plate like this. So when such a metallic plate is taken, eddy currents are developed in the whole area of metallic plate like this. When this metallic plate is introduced into a changing magnetic field, eddy currents are developed in the whole area of this metallic plate. But at the same time, when we use a metal plate like this with some slots, what is the advantage? Here, the lesser area is available for the eddy currents now. So, in the presence of magnetic field, the damping is also reduced because less amount of eddy currents are developed in the metallic plate now. And the relative motion of the conductor continues for a longer period. Because eddy currents are responsible for the opposition to the movement of the conductor. In the absence of more eddy currents, the opposition also decreases and the conductor continues to move between the pole pieces of the magnet for a relatively longer period of time. Okay, so that's all about the disadvantages of the eddy currents and the steps taken to minimize this eddy current. Okay.